Well, it's not often until the piece of legislation takes effect that people absolutely become aware of it. But as we get closer to the implementation, people become more aware. And that's certainly what's happening in respect of the Tobacco Products Directive, which, of course, started in Europe 2 or 3 years ago. And we have lobbied and made the case in Europe, but regrettably, we haven't been successful. So we will have the legislation coming forward, but we have done what we can. And we now understand the legislation. It's now it takes effect. It'll be for us to see whether the consequences are what people are concerned they might be, and to then continue to lobby government to effect some change.
I think it has to. I think the TPD in its strictest interpretations causes such problems for the industry to keep on the market it's the products that consumers want, that for the government not to take a light touch means that this industry's got real problems, and sadly the consumer loses out big time.
I do. I think at the minute it's one of the most important things that can happen. I think the last 18 months have seen a lot of undermining of e-cigarettes in the media, with a lot of very poor quality studies. And I think smokers have completely lost confidence in the concept of harm reduction and using an e-cigarette to kind of, even if slowly, transition away from smoking. And as much as other vapers can do a lot of work, I think public health groups like Public Health England and the various faculties of public health and the NGOs need to be being very clear on the fact that nicotine is not the problem. Nicotine itself is not really much of a concern. The danger comes from combusting tobacco. I mean, it's a very simple principle.
And there's no doubt that this is going to be the smoking cessation revolution, and Department of Health needs to get behind it. I mean, there is endorsement from the Department of Health, and importantly from Public Health England. I mean, if nothing else, the statement from Public Health England that e-cigarettes are 95% or more less risky than smoking is extremely important. The public need to know that message.
Well, I think that was quite significant, and you know, I got involved in e-cigarettes because there's a member of my team who's been using e-cigarettes for many years and was worried about the impact on his ability to continue to enjoy e-cigarettes and get his nicotine that way rather than switching back to tobacco, that caused me to get involved. You know, the Public Health England report that came out towards the end of last year, I think, was a real turning point, and I wanted the Prime Minister to acknowledge that report, which he did in his answer to me, and he acknowledged how effective e-cigarettes have been with many people switching from tobacco, and of course getting the health benefit that goes hand in hand with that.
Well, there's lots of concerns about how it was implemented, but in terms of impact, I think a lot of people still don't know what's coming. It's a big surprise for most vapers. There's only a small group of vapers who know what's going on and were part of the process and aware of the process. Most smokers don't realise, and certainly most vapers don't realise, and they're going to realise when their vape shops aren't there anymore, or they suddenly can't buy their e-liquid, or suddenly the price has increased, or whatever it is. And all of those huge changes are going to put the smoker or the new vapor in the position of making a decision whether they carry on vaping, which has now become harder to do, or take the easy option and go back to smoking.
So we know that 90% of the products or thereabouts that are currently on the market get taken off through a strict interpretation of the TPD. And the reality is that if we end up in that situation, we're into a scenario where we simply don't know whether e-cigarettes can continue to have the public health benefits that we've seen so profoundly over the last several years.
I think the biggest issue is the barrier that it will create for new people looking to switch. The fact that the devices are not going to create the same kind of satisfaction. The fact that the e-liquids are not going to be strong enough for someone who is just moving away from a serious smoking habit. If you're smoking 40 fags a day, going on to an 18 or 20 milligram just won't satisfy your cravings potentially. And therefore that person's not going to feel the benefit, and they're not going to have that experience that we've all had of moving through the upgrades of equipment and down the nicotine strengths and getting to a point where cigarettes are a thing of the past.
The worst thing about this point in time is uncertainty. The one thing that we do know is so far there are no problems with all the things that were proposed to be problematic with respect to toxicity of nicotine, with respect to renormalizing smoking, with respect to gateway effects of children coming in through e-cigarettes. All of the evidence taken in aggregate shows overwhelmingly that these things are not happening.
I think it's going to compound a lot of fears. People are going to see it as a way of justifying everything they've heard in the media. That there's something inherently wrong with e-cigarettes, and so that they need some kind of heavy and burdensome regulation in order to make them safe for the end user. I think it's going to scare a lot of people off. I think a lot of people are going to put down what they've got because they can no longer use it, because they can't refill it, or they can't get the support anymore, and they're going to go back to smoking. And I think it's going to mean a lot of smokers don't transition at all.
It's basically unnecessary. We could achieve what's in the TPD by other means, through product standards, through codes of advertising practice and so on.
We know there's something like 2.6 million vapers now, and that's a lot of people with a lot of influence. And what we really need those vapers to do is to get in touch with their local members of parliament to make sure they know what the impact of this TPD coming forward in May is likely to be. And then make sure that MPs are aware of what's happening. And when MPs want to know more, we've set up, and we've been running now for about 18 months, the all-party parliamentary group. And we can inform and invite those MPs along to our meetings, and we really do want to see more representation from MPs, but it will be for vapers themselves, who are a strong and active and vocal group of people, to get that message across to their MPs to take very seriously the legislation that's coming down the line.